Hey there guys, I'm Jesse Crowe, the traveling scientist. And today we're going to be looking at ibuprofen. How does it work and is it safe to use on a regular basis? Ibuprofen, also known as Motrin, Ibu, Nurofen, and like 50 other names, is a non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drug used to treat things like inflammation, pain, fever, toothache, cramps, arthritis, whatever ails you. Basically, when the cells in your body are damaged, they release arachidonic acid, which gets converted by an enzyme called cyclooxygenase, or COX, into prostaglandins. And prostaglandins promote things like pain, fever, inflammation. It's not good. Now, ibuprofen works to inhibit the COX enzyme, or in other words, it COX blocks arachidonic acid to prevent the production of prostaglandins, thereby reducing pain and fever. This is really similar to how we think paracetamol works, and I made a video about that. You can check it out. But the difference is that ibuprofen has an anti-inflammatory effect that paracetamol doesn't have. So it'd be better for treating things like sore muscles and arthritis. Ibuprofen also acts on the hypothalamus in your brain, causing vasodilation. Word of the day! Vaso, meaning vessel, usually blood vessel, and dilation, meaning becoming wider, or constriction, meaning becoming narrower. So this vasodilation brings the blood vessels closer to the surface of your skin, cooling down your blood and thereby helping to reduce fever. Finally, COX also creates an enzyme called thromboxane, which makes the platelets in your blood vessels really sticky. They clump together, forming blood clots, which can get lodged in your blood vessels, leading to things like pulmonary embolism, deep vein thrombosis, myocardial infarction. Basically, you're gonna die. So by inhibiting COX, ibuprofen actually reduces your risk of blood clot and pretty much saves your life. Whoa, it's not all drugs and smiles, all right? Ibuprofen can be pretty dangerous if it gets into the wrong hands. Some of the common side effects of ibuprofen include headache, which is totally counterintuitive. I mean, they're used to treat headaches. Diarrhea or constipation, which also is like completely counterintuitive. They're two completely opposite symptoms. Nausea and vomiting, which are common side effects in pretty much any drug. It's basically just your gut dealing with an unusual chemical and makes you feel a bit funny. Another possible side effect is itchiness, which could mean that you're allergic to the drug. How much would that suck? I mean, you're in pain and you're also allergic to the treatment.
Tough break, Five.
Ibuprofen can even lead to stomach pain. This is because COX also maintains your gastric mucosa. I know, COX does a lot of stuff. I mean, there's COX all over your body doing all sorts of things. You don't want to know. This means that when Ibu COX blocks, it damages the lining in your gut, which can lead to gastrointestinal bleeding. Stomach blood? Gross. Finally, if you're pregnant, non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs like ibuprofen and aspirin can cross the placenta, causing neonatal adverse effects like malformation and miscarriage. So if you're pregnant, do not take ibuprofen, do not take aspirin. If you're in pain, please talk to your doctor. Speaking of pregnancy, next week's video is going to be all about the pill and how to avoid pregnancy. So keep an eye out for that one. If you like this video, click the like button down below and let me know what you think of ibuprofen in the comments section down below. Finally, subscribe for more traveling science every single week and I'll see you guys next time. Cheers.